Hey folks, so welcome to the Salty Seaman. Today we're going to do the top 10 hard rock songs related to the military. Now, this is a very wide spectrum of music, obviously, and war and military preoccupies a lot of these bands, especially more in the metal genre, but we'll get to a bunch of others that aren't quite metal, but in the hard rock grouping. Now, I specifically kept it to this genre as it being the one I know the most, and just trying not to create a top 10 from across spectrums. I mean, country itself can fill a list, as well as pop music and probably many other genres. But for right now, I'm just going to stick to 10. I've chosen at least to be my inaugural top 10. I'm very open for future ones, Hard Rock Metal Part 2. I definitely want to do country. It's what I got to research on, but I know there's a lot, especially in the last 18 years. And a couple of great pop songs, military-related, I'd also like to do a top 10 on that. So if your favorite song is not listed here in the hard rock metal genre, please list it down in the comments below. I'd love to hear about it. I'd love to listen to them. Just between my friend and my brother, I got a bunch of ideas. Some songs I don't know, some that just didn't make the list. My brother recommended a band called Sabaton, which has a lot of great military-themed songs. I don't know the group. Five Finger Death Punch, who have served, which I think does add something to it, which I'll talk about a bit later, but I don't really know them that well. But everything I would like to get to, if people are interested in this type of countdowns, I'll do more in the future. But enough on that. Got some housekeeping on the way. Here we go, top 10 of the Salty Seaman's hard rock heavy metal songs about the military. Number 10, Soundgarden, Boot Camp. This one definitely maybe going under the radar for a lot of people unless you're a big Soundgarden fan, but I bought this album down the upside the day I graduated from boot camp, and this song, my God, did it speak to me. Chris Cornell, who never served, wrote this, and boy, it captures what boot camp is. It's short, sweet, it's kind of mellow, but it's in terms of kind of an esoteric exploration of what boot camp is and what it feels like. You can't go wrong with Soundgarden's Boot Camp. Megadeth, Hangar 18. One of the most tangentially related songs here, but if you know anything about Hangar 18 or the story of the song, basically it's the rumor going back to the 1940s, the crash in Roswell, which later was officially made a weather balloon, and even later something else, I can't remember, some kind of experimental craft. But of course the rumor is it was an alien spacecraft, and the Air Force recovered an alien aircraft and bodies of the deceased passengers, generally considered to be the graves. Of course, Hangar 18 is a place in Groom Lake, a recently declassified Air Force experimental aircraft testing facility, formerly known and probably most famously known as Area 51. Now, this is, again, kind of sort of military-related, but since there's very little Air Force on here, I wanted to give them a bit of a shout-out. And, of course, the song has the great line, military intelligence, two words combined that can't make sense, and anyone who served can agree with that one. Number 8, Iron Maiden, The Trooper. And we have more Iron Maiden, but just to give them their top billing, I'll give The Trooper. Iron Maiden, of course, had a ton of songs about military and warfare. You know, you can't get enough of, you know, The Trooper, of course, is one of the greatest opening lines, one of the greatest riffs in metal. Frontline battle just going on in this song. It's great. And they've done others, you know, Die With Your Boots On comes to mind, a very similar song. They did a couple about air battles. Aces High about World War I flying aces in combat, and a World War II version later on called Tail Gunner, a song for the Naval Sea Services, Run Silent, Run Deep, about submarines. There's Passchendaele. There's a ton. This is a group that has a lot of songs related to it. I'll give the nod to Trooper just over the rest of these, but these are all great songs by a great band. Bruce Dickinson served in territorial armies. He's one of the few on here who has actual service experience. Something I had a problem finding on this. Look, there are people who've served, but they don't seem to write about it a lot, at least not that I can tell. Maynard from Tool was in the Army. Fred Durst, Limp Bizkit was in the Navy. The entirety of Three Doors Down was in the Navy. But they don't seem to write a lot about that kind of stuff. I've heard Five Finger Death Punch does, another band I don't really know that much about, probably showing my age here. And they wrote a couple songs about military and service. So maybe check them out. Maybe they'll be in a future video.
Generals gathered in their masses.
Number 7. Can't Go Wrong with War Pigs by Black Sabbath. Maybe one of the original hard rock songs about war. Not a good song, not a pro-war song at all. This is a very anti-war, very mean to the generals and why they, why people who are of lower class have to go out and fight this awful war. And it's backed by, Ozzy's haunting vocals and amazing riffs by Tony Iommi. It's a classic, and it'll always be a classic, and it has a spot on this list.
You can smell a whiskey burning down Copperhead Road.
Number 6, Steve Earle, Copperhead Road. Continuing the idea of some Vietnam songs here. This one's a little more storytelling driven, about someone who goes to Vietnam. Learns a bit about the drug trade. I believe it's heroin specifically. He's starting to run heroin in Vietnam back to the States. He gets out of the military. He goes back to the rural South, I believe, and he's continuing to run drugs and evade police. And it doesn't end well, I don't think, on Copperhead Road. Certainly a song of the times. Great fucking song. Hard rock, rockabilly, country. It kind of is in the middle of all those, so I'm going to include it here. Also, it's just a great song. A couple others didn't quite get on here, that era, Fortunate Son, which a lot of people might be surprised about. I don't really consider it a military song, though it's so closely tied to Vietnam, and I consider it more of a class song, the poor versus the rich and who goes, but it is tied, and it's such a big song of the era, I have to at least mention it. And I guess I'll give a mention to Gimme Shelter by Rolling Stones, who it's a more esoteric kind of military Vietnam song, but I think it also deserves a mention.
Yeah, they come to snuff the rooster. Ah, yeah.
Number 5, Alice in Chains, Rooster. Still on this Vietnam kick. This one not told during the era, but from the children of them. Obviously, Jerry Cantrell from Alice in Chains. Father was a Vietnam vet, Army vet. The song is about his dad. If you watch the video, it's amazing. His dad's actually in it.
The war at all. I asked him about it one time. He asked us about that tonight. Remember, we were sitting on the porch drinking beer at night. It was summertime or something. And I asked him a question.
Sometimes you think, what the hell are we doing here, right? I watched my friends die.
That's where this song comes from. It's slightly esoteric. There's just enough, it's got that Alice in Chains depressing note to it. It's got all the feels. Definitely a good, from the soldier's perspective and the battlefield song. Alice in Chains, Rooster, absolutely belongs on this list. Number 4, Slayer, and we're going to go with War Ensemble here. No disrespect to Bitter Peace or Mandatory Suicide, also great songs. But if you think a war song by Slayer, you got to go War Ensemble, just for that great yell of war, lyrics. The battlefield is not a drill. It's how many people I can kill. I mean, it doesn't get harder, faster, more violent, more to the point of fucking war than Slayer's War Ensemble.
The brightest bitch I know. All the ones that gotta go.
Number 3, going off the track of known songs here, Bravest Kids by Rancid. This is on their Let the Dominoes Fall album. It's a real positive song I have on here. That's why I wanted to include it. Of the fact, it's a great fucking song. This is a tribute to the men and women who go over there and have to serve. The Lions, the bravest kids I know are the ones that got to go fighting over there. It's a very positive, you know, I'm hoping for the best for you guys. You kids are my heroes. You know, Rancid wrote a great tribute to the troops over there. A must listen if you have not heard it. There's a reason it's that high on my list. Number two, Metallica. Again, a lot of songs here. I'm trying to keep everything to one artist. I don't want to fill up the list. There's three ones here by Metallica. I'm going to put the winner over here as For Whom the Bell Tolls. They did a follow-up to this, Disposable Heroes on Master Puppets, and of course, For Whom the Bell Tolls on Ride the Lightning, both about battlefront troops and the horrors and indignity of war during battle. And the final follow-up to this trilogy is one on the Justice for All album based on the book Johnny Got His Gun and movie, which is used in the video for it. It's the aftermath of war. This is a song about someone who's been brutally destroyed in war, but is somehow still alive with no body parts, no senses, no nothing. Super depressing song. But in terms of this musicianship and the story, I have to give the nod to For Whom the Bell Tolls. And now for honorable mentions. I had a tough time calling this list. A few I liked had to be dropped. Number one, Sergeant Baker by Primus. I really love this song. I just didn't have room for it. It's kind of similar in tone to Boot Camp. It's about a drill instructor, Sergeant Baker. It seems to be very strongly based on Full Metal Jacket and, of course, Gunny Hartman, a.k.a. Arlie Ermey. Great song. Fun. Funky. Love it. System of a Down, Bring Your Own Bomb, BYOB. Kind of the War Pigs equivalent of War Pigs for the Iraqi War, done in System of a Down style. Of course, big radio hit, still going on. Great song. And a personal favorite, War Ghoul by Gwar. We all know Gwar is kind of a satire parody band. This is a really kind of epic song about just a creature, a demon of war, who's been through all the major battles of humans and just loves the chaos and is kind of a satire or a commentary on the human condition and warfare. A great song you haven't heard if you're used to just more of the funny, gross Slayer, Gwar stuff. Definitely check out War Ghoul from, I believe it's This Toilet Earth album. Or maybe it's Ragnarok. I can't remember. It's Ragnarok. Okay. Two albums. American Soldier by Queensryche. It's a full album about a soldier going off to war in Iraq, Afghanistan. Definitely worth a listen. It's one of Queensryche's better albums released past 1990, still with Jeff Tate. And a bit of an obscure classic, you punk rockers out there will know Mike Watt's Contemplating the Engine Room. Mike Watt of the Minutemen was a Navy brat. His dad was a retired Navy chief. When he wrote this, he has a whole album about the Navy and the Navy life. It's, if you're a sailor, if you have any interest in punk rock, this is the album to listen to. And my number one hard rock metal song relating to military.
16 years old when I went to the war to fight for a land fit for heroes.
Motorhead, 1916. Maybe you haven't heard, you definitely should. It does not sound like a typical Motorhead song. It is a very slow ballad. It has Lemmy playing violin on it, of all things. It's just a slow ballad about a young soldier in World War I and you know, all his big dreams and hopes of becoming a giant war hero and what actually happens to him in the Battle of 1916. It's a brutal, brutal, honest song. You know, it might surprise you coming from Lemmy and Motorhead, but it's so well done. It's a beautiful song, and I won't spoil it anything in it for you. I just say go check out Motorhead's 1916, my number one pick for military-related hard rock heavy metal songs. Now again, that's going to do it for the list, but I want to hear from you. I want to hear what songs I missed on this list, even from other genres. What would you suggest if I did a country list? What if I did a pop list? What if I did a hip-hop list? I really don't know. You know, I don't know a lot of songs in some of those genres that I could just make a top 10 off my head, but I'd be willing to listen and go research, and I could definitely easily do a part two of this one. Especially, I've heard about, my brother told me about Sabaton, that is a lot of military-related metal songs. their Iced Earth did a whole album on, I believe, the Civil War. I can't remember. I think I've listened to it before, but I have to go listen to it again. But definitely a ton of stuff there I can get to. Anything else you know, you think would be good for a series on this, let me know. But other than that, that's all the Salty Semen has to say for today. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, all the same things. Hit the subscribe button. If you're already subscribed, you want to make sure you get every single update. Ring the bell so you'll be part of my notification squad, and we'll get all the notifications when I upload new videos. That's all I got for now. Love you, freaks. War!